Hello friends, welcome to our channel Vidyanamastu. By saying learn what you love and love what you learn, we'll start with our video. In this video, we'll be learning chapter real numbers. Before starting with the chapter, we will know what are real numbers. Real numbers are the numbers that can be represented on the number line. For example, it can be anything 1, minus 1, 7.5, 3.2, etc. Now, we will begin with an important property known as Euclid's division lemma. Suppose, if we have any two integers a and b, there exists a unit integer q and r satisfying a equal to bq plus r, where r ranges from 0 to b. This equation a equal to bq plus r is in the form of division algorithms, where dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Euclid's division algorithm is a technique to compute the HCF of any two given integers a and b. So in order to find the HCF of any two given integers a and b, we need to follow some steps. In that, the first step is to apply the division lemma to a and b. So, we find the whole numbers q and r such that a equal to bq plus r, where r ranges from 0 to b. If the remainder r equal to 0, in the next step, the b is the HCF of given two integers a and b. But if the remainder r, which is not equal to 0, then we need to apply Euclid's division lemma to b and r. So b and r in the second step will become a and b in the next third step. So in third step we need to continue the process till the remainder will become 0. And if the remainder will become 0, at that step the divisor will be considered as the required HCF. Now, let us move to the exercise 1.1, where they have asked us to find the HCF of given two numbers using Euclid's division algorithm. In that, the first question they have given as 135 and 225. In this, we will solve it according to the stepwise. So, in step 1, we need to apply Euclid's division lemma to 225 and 135. Now, in 225 and 135, which one we have to consider as A and which one we have to consider as B? The greater number should be considered as A and the smaller number should be considered as B. So here, A we will get it as 225 and B we will get it as 135. Now, let us apply the formula A equal to bq plus r. Okay, here we have a equal to 225, which is equal to 135 into q plus r. So we can write it as 225 equal to 135 into 1 plus 90. So if you don't know how to solve this, I request you to divide 225 by 135. Okay, here 225 is the dividend and 135 is the divisor. So if we divide, you will get quotient as 1 and remainder as 90. Okay, now in this step, r remainder is not equal to 0. So we need to go to second step. Since r is not equal to 0, we have to apply Euclid's division lemma to b and r, that is 135 and 90. Okay. Now here, a will become 135 and b will become 90. Now again, apply the formula a equal to bq plus r. On substituting the values, we will get 135 equal to 90 into 1 plus 45. Again, If you have any doubt here, I would request you to divide 135 by 90 so that you will get quotient as 1 and remainder as 45. Now again, we don't have r equal to 0. So we need to again apply Euclid's division lemma to 90 and 45. That is b and r. Now here a will become 90 and b will become 45. Again apply the formula a equal to bq plus r. So on substituting the values, we will get 90 equal to 45 into 2 plus 0. Oh great. Now the remainder has become 0. Since the divisor at this stage is 45, we need to consider 45 as the HCF of 135 and 225. Now let us move to the second question, that is 196 and 38,220. This is of the higher values. Okay, let's solve it. In step 1, we need to apply Euclid's division lemma to 196 and 38,220. So the greater number is 38,220. We need to consider it as A, and smaller number 196 we need to consider it as B. Here we have A equal to 38,220 and B equal to 190. Now we need to apply the formula A equal to BQ plus R. Okay, since this is a greater number, I am going to solve it here. So we will divide 38,220 by 196. Okay, now here when this 196 is multiplied by 1, we will get it as 196 here. Okay, now we need to subtract 196 by 382, we will get it as 186. Since 186 is not divisible by 196, we will put this 2 here. Now on multiplying 196 into 9 times, we will get it as 1764. Now subtract 1764 by 1862, we will get it as 980. Now multiplying 196 into 5, we will get it as 980 here. Therefore the remainder will become 0. Now here we have dividend equal to 38,220, which is A, and divisor, that is B, we have 196, and quotient Q we have 195. Therefore we can put it here, 38,220 equal to 196 into 195 plus remainder as 0. Okay, now we are lucky that we got the solution in the first step itself. So at this stage we have divisor as 196, therefore 196 is the HCF of 38,220 and 196. Now moving on to the third question, we have 867 and 255. Now in step 1, we will apply Euclid's division lemma to 867 and 225. So here the greater number is 867 and the smaller number is 255. Therefore A we will get it as 867 and B we will get it as 225. Now we need to apply the formula A equal to BQ plus R. So when we apply, we will get 867 equal to 255 into 3 plus 102. So if you don't get this, divide 867 by 255, you will get quotient as 3 and remainder as 102. Since the remainder is not equal to 0, apply Euclid's division lemma to B and R, that is 255 and 102. Now here A will be 255 and B will be 102. So again, applying the formula a equal to b cube plus r, we will get 255 equal to 102 into 2 plus 51. Okay, again, if you don't get, divide 255 by 102, you will get quotient as 2 and remainder as 51. Now again, we don't have remainder as 0. Again, we need to apply Euclid's division lemma to B and R, that is 102 and 51. Now here we will get A as 102 and B as 51. Now again, applying the formula A equal to BQ plus R, we will get 102 equal to 51 into 2 plus 0. Great, we have got remainder as 0 here. Now the remainder has become 0. Since the divisor at this stage is 51, we need to consider 51 as a HCF of 135 and 225. Therefore, the solution is 51. Now, moving on to the second question, they have asked us to show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6 cube plus 1 or 6 cube plus 3 or 6 cube plus 5, where q is some integer. Now, let a be any odd positive integer. We need to prove that a is of the form 6 cube plus 1 or 6 cube plus 3 or 6 cube plus 5, where q is some integer. Now, applying the Euclid's division lemma, we get a equal to bq plus r for some integers q. Now, let us consider b equal to 6, that is divisor as 6. Now, we get a equal to 6q plus r for some integers q and r equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, since r ranges from 0 to 6. Therefore, a equal to 6q or 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 2 or 6q plus 3 goes on till 6q plus 5. Now, since a is divisible only by 2, it cannot take the values 6q, 6q plus 2 and 6q plus 4. Also, 6q plus 1, we can write it as 2 into 3q plus 1, which is equal to 2 into k1 plus 1, where k1 is any positive integer. Now next we have 6q plus 3, which can be written as 6q plus 2 plus 1. So on simplifying, on taking 2 as a common term out, we will get 2 into 3q plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2 times k2 plus 1, where k2 is an integer. Now we have left with 6q plus 5, which can be written in the form of 6q plus 4 plus 1. Now in 6q plus 4, we have 2 as a common term, which is equal to 2 into 3q plus 2 plus 1, which we can write it as 2 into k3 plus 1, where k3 equal to 3q plus 2, which is an integer. Now clearly, 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 5 are in the form of 2k plus 1, where k is an integer. Therefore, 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 and 6q plus 5 are odd numbers. Therefore, any odd integer can be expressed in the form of 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5, where q is an integer. An army of 616 members is to march behind an army band of 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of columns. What is the maximum number of columns in which they can march? So the maximum number of columns in which the army and the band can march will be given by HCF of 616 and 32. Therefore, we need to find the HCF of 616 and 32, which can be solved using Euclid's division lemma. Now in step number 1, we will apply Euclid's division lemma to 616 and 32, where A is considered as a greater term, that is A equal to 616 and B equal to 32. On applying the formula, we will get A equal to BQ plus R, which can be written as 616 equal to 32 into 19 plus 8. Okay, here, since the remainder R is not equal to 0, we need to apply Euclid's division lemma to B and R, that is 32 and 8. So in the next step, we have A equal to 32 and B equal to 8. So on applying the formula A equal to BQ plus R, we will get it as 32 equal to 8 into 4 plus 0. Okay, now we have got remainder as 0. In this stage, the divisor we have got it as 8. Therefore, the HCF of 616 and 32 is 8. Now, moving on to the fourth question. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. Okay, now let a be any positive integer. We need to prove that a is of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. Now let a equal to bq plus r, where b is considered as 3, which is given in the question. Applying Euclid's division lemma, we get a equal to 3q plus r for some integers q and r equal to 0, 1 and 2. R ranges from 0 to 2. Therefore, a equal to 3q or 3q plus 1 or 3q plus 2. Now, since they have asked us to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1. Therefore, we need to square on both the sides of a equal to 3q and a equal to 3q plus 1 and a equal to 3q plus 2. So now, let us square a equal to 3q. On squaring, it will become a square equal to 3q the whole square. Or 3q plus 1 the whole square, or 3q plus 2 the whole square. Now, this after squaring, we will get it as a equal to 9q square, or 3q plus 1 is in the form of a plus b the whole square. On solving, we will get a square plus b square plus 2ab. A square we have 3q the whole square, that is 9q square, plus 2ab. 2 into 3q into 1, that is 2 into 3q is 6, plus 1 the whole square, 1 square is 1. Therefore, we will get it as 3q square plus 6q plus 1. Or, squaring this 3q plus 2, we will get 3q square as 9q square. And 2 into 3q into 2, we will get it as 12q. And 2 square, we will get it as 4. Now, here, we need to get it in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. Therefore, 9q square, this can be written as 3 into 3q square. 3 into 3q square. Or in this 9q square and 6q, we have 3 as a common term. Therefore, this can be written as 3q square, 3 into 3q square plus 2q plus 1 as it is, we will write it here. Or even here in 9q square plus 12q, we have 3 as a common term. Therefore, we will take 3 out and inside the bracket, we will get 3q square plus 4q plus 3. So this 4 we have splitted into 3 plus 1 here. Therefore, 3 we have taken inside and plus 1 we have kept it outside. Now, we can write this 3q square as m1 and this 3q square plus 2q as m2 and 3q square plus 4q plus 3 we can write it as m3, where m1, m2 and m3 are integers. Therefore, we will get it as a square equal to 3 into m1 or 3 into m2 plus 1 or 3 into this m3 plus 1. Therefore, the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. Now, moving on to the fifth question. Use the Euclid's division lemma to show that the cube of any positive integer is in the form of 9m, 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. Now, let a be any positive integer and b equal to 3. Now, this can be written in the form of a equal to bq plus r, which will become a equal to 3q plus r, where q is not equal to 0 and r varies from 0 to 3. R can be varied from 0, 1, 2, 0, 1 and 2. Therefore, when r is equal to 0, we will get a equal to 3q. When r is equal to 1, we will get a equal to 3q plus 1. And when r is equal to 2, we will get a equal to 3q plus 2. Now, they have asked us to show that the cube of any integer is of the form 9m plus 9m, 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. Therefore, we need to cube this on both the sides of a equal to 3q, a equal to 3q plus 1 and a equal to 3q plus 2. Therefore, every number can be represented in these forms. In case 1, when a is equal to 3q, on cubing both the sides, it will become a equal to 3q the whole cube. Now, 3q the whole cube, we will get it as 3 cube, which is 3 into 3 into 3, we will get it as 27q cube. Okay, this 27q cube, we need to get it in the form of 9m. So, this we can write it in the form which is equal to 9 into 3q cube, which is equal to 9m1, where m1 is equal to 3q cube, which is an integer. Now, in case 2, when a equal to 3q plus 1, on cubing both the sides, we will get a cube equal to 3q plus 1 the whole cube. Now, on solving this expression, we will get a cube equal to 27q cube plus 27q square plus 9q plus 1. Now, we have to bring this in the form of 9m plus 1. Therefore, here in 27q cube, 27q square and 9q, we have 9 as a common term. Okay, now 9 we will take it out. And here we will get After taking 9 out, we will get 3q cube as we got it in case 1 here, and plus 9 into 3q square plus 9q plus 1. So in all these 3, 9 we have common. So taking this 9 out, we will get 9 into 3q cube plus 3q square plus q, and outside we have 1 as it is. So this 3q cube plus 3q square plus q, we can write it as m2, which is an integer. Therefore a cube will become 9 into m2 plus 1. Therefore we have got a cube as 9 m2 plus 1. Now in case 3, we have a equal to 3 cube plus 2. Now we need to cube on both the sides. Therefore this will become a cube equal to 3 cube plus 2, the whole cube. On cubing this, we will get the expression as a cube equal to 27q cube plus 54q square plus 36q plus 8 by applying the formula a plus b the whole cube. Now in these three terms we have 9 as common term. Okay, this 9 after we take it out, inside the bracket we will get it as 3q cube plus 6q square plus 4q plus this 8 as it is. Now taking this 3q cube plus 6q square plus 4q as any integer m3, we can write a cube as a cube equal to 9m3 plus 8. Therefore the cube of any integer is of the form 9m, 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. Thank you friends. If you have liked this video, please hit a like button and subscribe to my channel so that you will get regular updates when I upload the video. So your support is very important for me so that I can come up with more videos in more interesting way as possible. Thank you friends.